right after it is. I explained in the first beginning class that second project is going to be a light. Because light is a physical quantity, our physics are not, tell me. So we are introducing that way to make you the light. So because if I ask you, what is the light intensity in this room right now? Can anyone say that? What is the light intensity in this room right now? Very important. Hey, have you ever seen that movies are made, no? What they do? They reflect the light rays on the actors. The light boys, they are called light boys. So directors and cameramen will indicate them that this way, that way, like that. So that light reflectors are focused towards, because that means there is another person who is keep on measuring the light intensity on the actors. So, but how do they measure the light intensity? Because you know for sure that there are n number of measurements for n number of different quantities. Yes or no? For example, as we have discussed in the first class about electrical power is measured in what?
Watts.
Okay. And similarly, light. Today our project is on light activated switch. And we need to understand first the reason I developed this project for you. I told you, CCL is not only about all electronics and heat circuits. No, I very much told you to make you more and more interested in learning physics, understanding physics, working physics, fun with physics. What is that I specially developed so that the physics phobia is thrown away? Yesterday, IIT results have come. Lot of people are talking about physics in the newspapers, right? Though the physics paper was so tough, what is tough if you work properly? And the basics are well explained, well clear in your mind. Then why you say that it is so tough? No one can say that, right? That's why to make you feel more comfortable, I am introducing these concepts while you can make them on your own with your own hands. So, projects. So then projects, because you all are interested in understanding the projects, that's where what happened? You have come here. Ultimately, you are connecting to the physics with more fun. So now you won't be having any phobia in physics. What you will be doing is you will be enjoying physics just as soon as these classes are over. That's where I am telling you, today's light activated switch is working with your measurement of light. How nice is that? Okay, see, the light intensity is measured in candela. So, photometer is a device which measures the light intensity. What is the device name?
Photometer.
Photometer. So, that particular, now that movie recording is going on, what they do is that reflect light boys are there and a photometer boy is also there. What he does is that the cameraman send him and the photometer boy, what he will do is he will keep the photometer on the actor's face, actor's body. So that he will check the light intensity falling on the actor. If it is not sufficient for him to take a better quality movie, picture, then what he will do is, he will indicate light boys. And the light boys will increase the intensity of light falling on the actors more and more by more and more using reflectors and concentrating, focusing on the actors properly. Then this candela meter, that photometer, will say once it the man finds the required candela, energy has come out there, light energy is falling on it, the actors, then that means you will make sure to the cameraman, yes, now I am sure that reflected rays will be into camera sufficient enough to give you the good quality picture. So that boy will go away and then the cameraman press the button to record that. You understand, my dear friends, how nice is that? So tomorrow with this project, you can also make your photometers. If you understand this project. So that's what I told you. See, my Guru Dakshina for me is going to be the one who give me the maximum applications of the projects explained in the class. So today I am going to explain this project. So where are the applications? What are all the applications you all can do? N number of applications. Thoughts are yours. Okay? But understand the basics here. With this basics, apply your mind and then find out the n number of applications. And the one who give me the n number of applications, and that is going to be my big Guru Darshan. You understand? Thanks about it. And now, see, you know that that switch is there. 9 volt positive switch. And this is the power line, this is the power line. This is the negative power line, that is the positive. So that is going to energize the circuit. Now, okay. Now, where is the LDR? Here is the LDR. And LDR also, what is LDR? Light depending resistor. So once it is resistor and light depending resistor, that means the value of the resistance is based on the light rays falling on the resistor. Very interesting, no? Now you must ask me a question.
How it works?
How it works, one thing, internal phenomena of working, the principle and all, fine, different. But before that, we need to work with the specifications as well, the basics of the LDR. So now there are two things, like it's varying to the minimum to the maximum, to the minimum and to the maximum. The resistance between, resistance of the LDR is varying from minimum to the maximum, right? If I say that, it's not really correct. Theoretically, of course, up to some extent it is correct, but practically it is not correct because there are so many limitations for you to make a LDR with a minimum to the maximum. Minimum is supposed to be zero, maximum is supposed to be infinite, but practically it is not possible to make that LDR to come out with a resistance to zero to infinite, that extreme ends. That's why what we do, we call them that. Now here is a very critical important point, one has to have a thorough understanding of it, okay? Now in LDRs, we call it as dark resistance. The most important specification of LDR is what? Dark resistance, okay? That means the component, the LDR offers resistance. Whenever light rays falls on them, whenever the light rays falls on them, the resistance between LDR goes low. Suppose say, that's supposed to be actually a minimum, that means zero, but practically it's not possible. So we can say to the lowest possible, okay? Maybe in the order of few ohms, maybe in between 10 to 30 ohms, okay? So that is called when light rays are falling on it, okay? That is in between 10 to 30 ohms, suppose say. That means if the LDR is properly placed with the maximum light intensity of sun and all, then you will see the resistance is somewhere between 10 to 30 ohms. Not that it is totally zero. It's not that totally minimized. Okay. So, but however, comparatively, the dark resistance of LDR, the value of this particular light resistance, okay, is very much less. Because the dark resistance, if I ask you, what is going to be dark resistance, for example, theoretically infinite. Supposed to be infinite. Okay, infinite means countless. But however, as I told you, it is not possible to make that practical thing. So, up to some extent, the dark resistance of LDR is in the order of some megaohms. Megaohms. Few megaohms. Few hundreds of megaohms. Few megaohms. For example, take even 1 megaohm. 1 megaohm is also quite high. Why? Because mega means 10 raised to 6. It's very big, no? Comparatively 10 and 20. 10 raised to 6 is a big number. Yes or no? How many zeros after 1 it is going to be 10 raised to 6? 10 into 10 into 10 into 10 into 10 into 10. How big is that? So out of that number, then the 10 is very less. So the dark resistance of that LDR is equal in the order of megaohms, and the day resistance when the light rays are falling on that particular LDR, the resistance is so low. So if you want to check that LDR, what you need to do, connect LDR to our regular resistance meter, DMM in resistance mode, and then show to the sun rays. Then that resistance must be in the order of 10 to 30 ohms. Fine? Good? Yes or no? And then once again, you need to close the entire LDR so that no light ray is entering into that inside LDR, so that the resistance must go in the order of megaohms. If that is the case happening, don't you think that the LDR is working? Yes, working. Now, intermediately, if you are finding some 10 kilo or 50 kilo or 100 kilo ohm resistance and all, what is the point in? It is not 10 to 30 ohms, so that no direct light rays are falling on it. And also not megaohms, so that it is supposed when you try to measure the resistance of the LDR, if it is say 50 kilo or 100 kilo, then what is it indicates?
It's not properly closed.
It is not properly closed, common sense. And also, someone can say, Bharatwaj, tell me, it is not properly closed, okay. That is one answer. Other answer in the same way?
once will you repeat the question?
Oh, that means anyone followed me when I'm explaining? Answer me. He said that means it is not properly closed. Okay, Bharata, sit up. Someone else, Vinita, come and tell me, explain.
It's, it was open.
Otherwise it is not properly closed, he explained, no? Anybody else wanted to answer me in different fashion?
It's not properly connected.
No, it was connected.
Of course, that is also problem. But suppose the solution is proper, partially?
No,
that's what you told
me.
Yes, that is what I'm expecting. That means some light rays are getting leaked. From the way you closed is not the proper. Somewhere the light rays are leaked and falling onto the LDR where it is not going to the mega home area. Okay. So totally it is not going to high, totally it is not at low. It is in between. That means light rays are leaking and falling. Now when I explain you this case so clear, don't you think that now the resistance can be from 10 ohms to 1 mega, linearly also we can see, allowing and closing the light rays onto that? That is nothing but making a photometer. So we can make a photometer, okay, with the using of LDR also, for example. Then measuring the resistance of this LDR is going to help you. What is the light intensity falling on LDR? So you need to develop a scale between the resistance to the light rays. Automatically, whatever resistance you are finding, yes or no? That is nothing but proportional to the light rays falling on it. Then you can say that sufficient light or not, yes or no. See, that's where I told you, Vinita and Naimisha, creating creators, yes or no. So, I don't teach, but I create environment for you to do and exercise on this given platform and the environment. This is the specialty of this children's service lab designed by your science friend Srinivas. Okay, my dear friends? Anyway, now let me go into deeper. So now you understand the functionality of LDR. I will give you the LDR in the project box. You will see them. Okay?
Dear students, I hope you enjoyed this video, how to make light activated switch. Through this video, I am sure you learned lot much. And if you wanted to do many more projects, you can join Children's Circuit Lab. And once again, I'm happy to announce that it is going to start from 1st June 2014 at Sri Gautami Smart School, Rajahmundry.